Welcome to the St. James United Methodist Church.
Welcome to the St. James United Methodist Church.
Welcome to the St. James United Methodist Church.
Good morning, and welcome to the St. James United Methodist Church. I'm Reverend Lynn Menser, and along with the Savoy family, and Carol Maroney, Darlene Skeen, and Kyle Sanborn, and Rayla Falou, we welcome you to this worship and pray that this time together will bless you in all the ways that only you and God know you need to be blessed. One of our traditions here at St. James has been to take a deep breath as we prepare for worship, to breathe in the Holy Spirit and to settle down and to allow the Spirit room to work within us, to grow within us, to be the breath within us. But this week, in violent contrast, the image of life-giving breath being forced from George Floyd by a Minneapolis police officer was burned into our consciousness and into our cities. And so, in addition to praying for our loved ones today, for Dexter and Beth and their family, for Joe's sister Paula and Pam's sister Beth, and for Dave's sister-in-law, Karen, on the loss of her mother, I'd like to share these words, inspired by a prayer written by our bishop and members of the cabinet this week. I invite you to join me in a spirit of reflection and repentance. Let us pray. O God, forgive us for the sin of racism, and for failing to make peace with justice a reality for all your people. When racist systems, policies, laws, and institutions prevail, we can't breathe. Forgive us for thinking, if things are fine and fair for me, they're fine and fair for everyone. When injustice is ignored or shrugged off, we can't breathe. Forgive us for allowing the differences that make us special in your eyes to lead us to judgment and violence in our streets. When we fail to see you in the other, we can't breathe. Breathe on us, breath of God. Breathe healing and health on those who struggle. Breathe your grace on those whose hearts are grateful. Breathe peace on those who fear. And breathe your justice on every country, city, neighborhood, and heart. Oh God, we can't breathe. Forgive us and fill us with your Spirit until there's room for nothing else. And let the people say, Amen.
Please join us in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Today is Trinity Sunday. We believe in one God, but we experience God in three ways: the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That's the Trinity. God the Father is our creator and the source of our strength. He sent his Son Jesus to teach us how to pray and how to love one another. The Holy Spirit guides us. Oh, this stool is a little wobbly. I think I'm going to switch. Notice how this stool kind of wobbles on the uneven ground? I have this other stool. It's called a milking stool, and it has three legs. The farmers used to use the three-legged stool because it was more stable on an uneven barn floor. And I think that'll be more stable here. It's kind of like the three parts of the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And when we have something more stable, we can get over the bumps in our lives a lot easier. So let's pray. Dear God, thank you for being there, for creating this wonderful world that we live in, and for sending your Son Jesus to teach us how to love you and how to love one another, and for sending us the Holy Spirit as our guide. Amen.
Today's scripture reading is from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. Everything on earth has its own time and its own season. There is a time for birth and death, planting and reaping, for killing and healing, destroying and building, for crying and laughing, weeping and dancing, for throwing stones and gathering stones, embracing and parting. There is a time for finding and losing, keeping and giving, for tearing and sowing, listening and speaking, There is also a time for love and hate, for war and peace. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God.
That reading from Ecclesiastes was so appropriate for today. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. It's appropriate for our current challenges in dealing with the coronavirus.
A time to wear masks and maintain physical distancing, and a time to put masks and distancing behind us.
Right. And it's appropriate for sharing exciting news.
A time to answer God's call faithfully.
Yes, right again. So Jen, I understand that you recently learned of a ministry opportunity and that you said yes. So tell us what you know so far.
So at this time, it looks like I will be beginning my internship at Wesley United Methodist Church in Concord, New Hampshire in September. I'll be working with Reverend Cheryl Meachin. The rest of the details are still in the works.
How do you feel about this opportunity? Do you feel that it's another example of God guiding you along your spiritual path?
Yes, definitely. I needed to do a contextual education placement, and this will be a great opportunity. I had originally requested an appointment as pastor to a church, but after some discernment, I've decided that this is what I need to do at this time.
So how about your family and BU? You've been attending Boston University for a while now.
Just finishing my third year.
Yes. How will this internship affect your family, and will you have time to finish up your classes at BU?
Yes. So the internship is about 20 hours a week, and that includes a class that I'll be taking at BU that's related to the internship as a contextual ed placement. Also, BU is offering students the option to attend classes online for the fall semester, and I plan to take advantage of that, and that will give me a little bit more time with my kids and more time for the internship.
Perfect. It sounds perfect. I realize you'll be working out the details with Reverend Meachin as you go along, but what are the things you're really hoping to do or to learn during your time at Wesley?
Well, I'm looking forward to being exposed to another way of doing ministry. Mm-hmm. Every church is different, and I look forward to seeing how Wesley does ministry in their context. I'm also looking forward to working with Reverend Meachin. I know her from Wanakee, and she's a great pastor.
Oh. So you've been a member here at St. James for how long?
23 years. I started here when Rhea was about 5 months old.
Oh. Over the years, you've been active here at St. James in so many ways. Through Sunday school, VBS, Bible study. You've been a lay leader, a delegate to annual conference. You have probably been a member of most every committee at one time or another. What are some of the gifts that you'll take with you from your time here at St. James?
Well, I love working with the youth and the kids, so I'm hoping to get some opportunity to do more of that at Wesley. But also, I just really am looking forward to seeing where God leads me and how God helps me to learn skills that are outside of what I've already done.
Mm-hmm. I think it's safe to say that you and your family hold a special place in the heart of this congregation. They've watched your children grow up, and in many ways, they've watched you grow up. Together, we've held you in prayer as you answered your call to ministry, as you completed your undergrad work, as you applied for and was accepted and attended BU. How would you like us to pray for you as you take these next steps?
Well, anytime there's a change, there's stress. St. James is my home. Yeah. And my heart will always be here, sorry. I'm so very thankful for the support that this church has given me over the years, especially the last 8 years or so. Sorry, I was trying to wait until I was done to do this. Prayers that this change will go smoothly and that my kids and I will settle into a new routine are much appreciated.
Yeah. Those are such good tears. Tears that come from the heart, and there will be tears as you go forth into this internship and yet tears of joy and pride and happiness too.
Yes, definitely.
And what might your prayer be for St. James?
I will always keep St. James and the people here in my prayers. That they'll continue to be a church that is filled with love and respect and caring for those around them. I've learned so much about serving God by serving God's people, and I pray that others will also know how much God loves them through the actions of this church body.
Mm-hmm. And you'll come to visit.
Oh, yes. my plan is that after the internship is done in April, that I'll be able to come back to worship for a while. And hopefully, you know, we'll be able to come to youth group and stuff over the next year. So,
I know the youth would like that.
Yeah.
I would like that too. And Hannah.
Yeah.
So before we move on to the Love Feast, is there anything else you'd like to share with your church family about this time of change and new beginnings?
I can't say enough how much I appreciate this congregation. You all are so special to me, and the love and support and encouragement I've received here means so much more than I can ever express. Thank you all so much. I love you all. Sorry.
Oh.
Happy tears, too. It's bittersweet.
Happy tears. And yeah. Tears that bless you.
Oh, yes.
And us.
Yeah.
Speaking of blessing, ordinarily, we'd be celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion right now. We'd be sharing the bread and juice of salvation. We'd be praying over the elements with the traditional words. But because of the virus, we're still not able to do that in the way that we're used to. And so for the past several months, we have been following Jesus' directive to do this in remembrance of me by sharing a love feast. And so this is our third Sunday now, third month of sharing a love feast.
So instead of bread and juice, we have a muffin and a cup of tea or water or coffee. And instead of one person presiding, we pray together, hear scripture together, and eat and drink together wherever we are.
True. And that's what the early Christians did too, and later the German Moravians. In fact, they were the ones who introduced John Wesley to the Love Feast back in 1737, and it was John's experience and opinion that it was a proper alternative way to share Jesus' holy meal in those situations when the traditional service could not be observed. So let's begin this month's Love Feast with a centering prayer.
Let us pray together. Gracious God, we know that you are with us wherever we are. We know that the risen Christ lives within and among us. We know that the Holy Spirit fills and guides your people. Be with us now, we pray, as we hear your word and share this simple meal, all to your glory. And let us say together, Amen.
Amen. The Love Feast begins with scripture. In John 8, verse 12, Jesus says, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. If you have a candle on your table at home, please light it now.
Jesus, you are the light of the world. Your light conquers every darkness.
In John 14, verse 6, Jesus says, I am the way and the truth and the life. If you have a Bible nearby, please hold it in your hands now.
Here's the story of God's covenant of steadfast love with God's people, from the beginning of time to this present moment and forever. Here is the assurance that nothing can ever separate us from God's grace and love.
In John 7, verses 37 to 38, Jesus says, Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who believes in me drink. Please lift and hold whatever you have prepared to drink.
Without water, there can be no life. When we thirst and when we drink, we remember the gifts of life, love, and grace that God has given us so abundantly. Let us drink together now.
And in John 6, verse 35, Jesus says, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." I invite you now to lift and to hold whatever it is you have prepared to eat this morning.
Jesus broke bread and fed the multitudes. He broke bread and formed a new covenant with his disciples and with us. Just as individual grains of wheat are gathered together to make one loaf, we who are scattered are one body in Christ. Let us break and eat bread together now.
Remember the times that you have received this bread and this juice in holy communion with the community of faith.
Remember those who are gathered and received with you.
Remember the presence of the risen Christ in that moment.
And be assured that his Spirit is with you in every moment of your life.
May the love of God, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you and within you, with us and within us, now and forevermore. And let us say together, Amen. Lord, we truly are grateful, grateful for everything. And here at St. James, we are grateful also for your generous and faithful support of the ministries that continue here, of the ways that we are working to stay connected and that you are helping to stay connected with our community. We are grateful for so many hidden blessings in this strange time of separation. But I invite you now to join me in the prayer of gratitude for God's generosity and prayer of dedication for the gifts that you continue to faithfully send to the church. Please pray with me. Gracious God, faithful Son, fiery Spirit, thank you for gifts beyond our deserving and for guiding us to use them to build your kingdom on earth. Bless the gifts we bring this day in our hands and hearts to serve you always. Amen. Our benediction today will be given by Amelia Savoy, and so I invite you now to listen and to join her in this blessing.
Go into the world with a daring and tender love. The world is waiting. Go in peace. And all that you do, do it for love. And by the Spirit of Jesus, who is the Lord. Amen.
Oh, God's grace got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud. Telephone wire, some just put up their hands apart. Is there anything they got now? Listen to the bassist, the one on the bottom of the wolf rock crook. Hit the bottom of the mountain rose in a big canoe. The old crowd just goes moon. Oh, God's grace got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud in the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands apart. Is there anything they got now? listen to the top a little bit, sing a melody with the high notes ringing. Oh, everything in the day will disagree. All God's critics got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing high, some sing out loud and down on wire. Them just clap their hands, the pause, is there anything to get now? Dog and a cat sitting there in the middle, honeybee hums and a cricket fiddle. The old man and the donkey bray, the old coyote howl. All God's critics got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands in the pot or anything to get now. Yes, this is a song sung everywhere by the ox and the fox and the grizzly bear, grumpy alligator and a huckleberry, the raccoon and the turtle dove. All God's critics got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud, telephone wire. Some just clap their hands upon, or anything to get me near.